There's one thing about Paul Molitor is if you ever meet him, he's one of the smartest guys you'll ever meet, especially about baseball. I mean, the guy just sees things in the game that, you know, most people don't see. And I think Tom Kelly had that knack, too. And, you know, Gardner did, too. You can't really, you know. But, you know, Molitor is one of those guys, you know, Hall of Fame talent. But because of that, he saw so many things, even just held from the pitchers, that kind of thing. So I think his overall knowledge, I think the players are, you know, it's going to help the players have that kind of, you know, smarts in the dugout to help out as a manager. But also, you know, it's going to be interesting to see how he kind of handles, like I said, with the pitching staff, with no experience. But he's definitely a guy who's a forward thinker. Last year he came in his first year, and you're right, he did bring in a lot of those infield shifts. I talked to Terry Ryan a little bit about kind of where he ranks in terms of all the candidates that interviewed about advanced stats. He said Molitor was probably more, you know, not, more in the middle, maybe probably about, like, long candidates. He wasn't quite as, you know, savvy as some of the guys, but definitely still knows his stuff and understands the shifts. And if you gave him, you know, one of the guys told me, like, if you gave Gardenhire a chart on, like, bunting, you know, the, you know, run expectancies, Gardenhire, I'm like, oh, okay, that's great, but he'd kind of go off his gut. I think Molitor's more math-inclined and more like, okay, well, if this is what they're telling me, all the numbers, then I'll go with the numbers, that kind of thing, whereas Gardenhire's more, yeah, I'll go with my gut and just punt this guy over to second no matter what.